Americans have gathered at the Zetra Arena tonight. Figure skating, pairs free skating at hand. What's known also as the long program. After the short program on Friday night, the standings look like this. The current world champions, Volova and Vasiliev, lead. Then a tie for second place involving Kitty and Peter Carruthers and the Soviet pair of Selezhneva and Makarov. And then in fourth place at the moment, you have the 1982 world champions, Bass and Tierbach from East Germany. Now, I think most of you know that the scoring in figure skating is extremely complicated, but I think we can simplify it for you. You saw the top three pairs. If any of those pairs wins tonight's long program, which is worth 71% of the overall score, they will take the title. It's as simple as that. They will mathematically clinch the gold medal. There were a lot of surprises. Problems were based in Tierbach, Underhill, and Martini on Friday. That really opened up the way for Kitty and Peter Carruthers. It opened the door, and they came through with flying colors as they are tied for second. And let me bring in Dick Button right now, and I'd like you to assess their chances of winning it all tonight.
Look, we've said right smack from the start that it's hard to determine who is going to win this championship. Any one of the top four pairs going into the championship could win it easily. Any one of the top four pairs could win any one of the medals or be left out in the cold. But now there's an added possibility, and that is the second Russian pair has been brought into the situation. So really, I mean, it's almost, it comes down to the classic case of which pair is going to do well, which one is going to mess it up and destroy their chances. And as far as Kitty and Peter are concerned, well, all I can hope is that they do what they've been telling me they're going to do, and which I believe they firmly believe themselves, and that is to skate well, the best that they can. They don't appear to be nervous. They don't appear to be hyper. They're not gunning for, they feel they have a chance to win the gold, but they don't, they're not worried about it if they don't. They seem to be in perfect spirit. So the most I think that we can hope for, and the best that we can hope for, is that they will have the opportunity to win at least one of those medals there.
Well, a great performance, a great routine turned in on Friday. There are some significant differences between the long program and the short program, and those are detailed for us by Peter Carruthers.
It's, first of all, it's a longer program. The short program is 2 minutes, 15 seconds max, and anything under is fine. Long program has to be 4:40, 4 minutes and 40 seconds or under. It's done with very few restrictions, except no acrobatic moves, such as backflips or somersaults. And there are some restrictions on where the man can place his hand on the woman's body. You can't touch her skates and fling her around with her skates. But as far as that's concerned, there's really no other restrictions, and just go have a good time.
Now, the Carruthers are one of three American pairs involved in this competition in Sarajevo, and we're going to take a look at one of the other American couples right now. Lee Ann Miller, 22 years old, from St. Louis, Missouri, and Bill Faber from Claymont, Delaware. Let's train along with the Carruthers in Wilmington, Delaware, under Ron Luddington.
Now, the thing to look for with this pair is the elegance of their line. They are a very sophisticated pair. Sometimes their technique is not as strong as it could be, but the line and the classical approach that they have to skating is really quite marvelous. Individual skaters move side by side, double lutzes right here. Very nice, very neat. They're quiet. They're calm skaters.
Miller and Faber in 10th place after the short program.
Difficult move coming up, a triple one hand overhead. Note the changing position, the stretch in the air, the changing leg position. This combination, side by side jumps. I must say, very nice. Thank you. nice beginning for this pair. Very nice.
Bill Farmer, 29 years old, did not start figure skating until he was 14.
This is the essence of their skating. Watch him jump right over her.
Crowd very enthusiastic about that move.
Jump over. Star lift.
The United States, and there are more Americans in the Zetra Arena than any other nationality, so if you can hear the USA, USA chant, which has become so prevalent at all of the events in Sarajevo.
And it's a very encouraging thing to have, know that so many people are for you in an audience. Their performance, always pleasant to watch, but marred by several mistakes. This was one of the overhead lifts. Now right here you can see that in the move from a two-handed position to a one-handed position right there, and with the back thing, he didn't quite sustain her and she dropped down early in the move. There were several mistakes through the performance that they suffered, and that was unfortunate. But look at this move where he does an axel right over the back of her leg in a back lunge position. I think they know that there were several mistakes. Uh-oh, and there are the marks coming up that clearly show that. Ah, unfortunate.
Yeah, they range all the way from 4-9, four judges marking them at 4-9, all the way up to the Czechoslovakian judge, who gave them a mark of 5.3, but right around the 5.051 range.
I think more interesting will be what they get for presentation. In my book, they're a very elegant pair, and the moves that they do require a great deal of training and stamina.
Well, the marks are slightly better here.
Not really.
Just a little bit better.
Not up to what they should have as far as artistic impression is concerned.
And they range from 4.9 up to 5.4 for Leanne Miller and Bill Farber.